無理さらに闇を抜け出した希望はより一層その輝きを増して鮮やかな一番に出てくるから Go ahead away またとない命燃やしてどまどいは Take your away どこまでも Just believe your way 世界と You are no victory 一心に放つ光で焼き付けてみせるよ想いを
I'm going back to help Seneca.
I'm so scared. Arthur, please!
You'll be just fine with these. Seneca enchanted them herself. They'll give you the courage you need to survive.
They will?
Sure they will. Now, have I ever lied to you? I'll come back for you once Seneca is safe. It's scary, but don't give in to fear. Don't despair, no matter what.
I won't. I promise. After all, I'm Mafi's older sister, and you're a student.
you On that day, the world began to change. Men and beasts possessed by evil spirits, hunting and killing anyone they could. But even in the depths of despair, only two things matter to me. The taste of blood-soaked flesh. And revenge upon one man.
Luffy, time to wake up. Okay. Morning.
I told you to stop calling me Luffy. I'm not a little kid anymore.
Grumble, grumble, huh? You must be feeling good. Bit of a fever, I'm afraid. At least the new medicine's supposed to come today. Until then, you stay in bed, got it?
What? Aw, but I wanted to go to the Cape.
Sorry, you'll have to wait.
Can I at least read a book?
Don't trouble your sister, Lafayette.
I didn't mean to.
Arthur, done chopping firewood?
Yeah, enough to last through winter. But there's something else I need to take care of. Sorry, but medicine money'll have to wait a bit.
I can earn it myself then. Bring down a few prickle boars, and I'll have plenty to offer in trade.
On your own?
Arthur's first maxim. Plans must be solid and reactions flexible.
All right. I shouldn't doubt my students' abilities. Sorry to put you in the spot.
I'm sorry, Velvet.
Whoa, hey! What's everyone apologizing for? We're a family, right?
Right. I'll see you later.
I whipped up some porridge for you, okay? Be back by evening.
Thank you. Be careful, Velvet.
The hunt for prickle boars, I'd better try the tranquil woods outside of town. This is for Luffy's medicine, so I can't mess this up. Come to think of it, Arthur hasn't requested his favorite dinner in a while. There's been so much going on, and the village always has him out hunting. Maybe he's just worn out? That does it! I'll cook him up some prickle boar stew, just like Celica taught me. That ought to pick him right up. A healthy portion of nourishing meat cures fevers and weariness alike. I should probably stock up on a few things before I go into the forest. I don't have a lot of money to spare, but like Arthur always says, battles are won and lost with the preparations made before the first strike.
Hey, Velvet! Is Lafayette feeling better?
No, not yet. He needs a little more rest, I think.
Aw, too bad. Tell him I'm looking forward to hunting beetles with him again when he's better.
Right, got it. Lafayette's illness sure is persistent. Yeah, that fever still keeps coming back, like clockwork. The medicine always helps a little bit, but still, that sounds terrible. Let me know if there's anything I can do to help. Thanks, but we'll be fine. At least we've got Arthur to take care of anything that needs muscle. And before he came, Celica raised me and Luffy all by herself. So now I have to do my best too.
You sound just like your sister. That optimism must run in the family.
I do? That's nice of you to say.
The demon blight is a punishment. Sent to us by the Empyreans for forgetting the old prayers.
Who are the Empyreans?
The four Empyreans created the world. The one Empyrean shall bring it to peace. Be afraid. When contradiction permeates this world, the time of suppression will be upon us.
Are you okay? Want me to take you home?
No! Don't treat me like a child!
All right, then.
Oh, it's you, Velvet. If you're going to the Cape, take care.
Don't fall into the Shrine of Tranquility, right? I know. I'm not a kid.
Of course, of course. You're 13 now, aren't you?
I'm 16. This area looks promising. There! Prickle Boar! Weather's been terrible on everyone's crops, but at least the city will buy our prickle boar meat now. Luffy and Arthur have been hoping the village could start raising them, but they can just be so temperamental. I wonder if they could be bred with more docile pigs. What would we call them? Oinkle boars? Nah, doesn't sound appetizing. What about pickle boar? Yeah, pickle boar! That's a cute name! Maybe too cute, though. We wouldn't want to discourage people from eating them. Your foes and strike where they're weak. Is that all?
Thank you.
Not bad. This should be enough to cover the medicine. I'd better bring these to the store. Boris, I hunted. Are you there? Maxim 3. Never waver once your sword is drawn. Control your feelings to control the tide of battle!
Pride and anxiety, pity for the enemy, thrill of victory. Your emotions run too hot. That will be your downfall. Agreed. It's one of her virtues as well.
Huh?
Yes, I know. But even so, she's got to...
Arthur?
Arthur's fourth maxim. Never let your guard down, even when victorious.
Got it.
In any case, this should be enough to buy Lafayette's medicine. I'll drop the prickle boars off at the shop before I head out.
Head out where?
The person I was supposed to meet is late. I don't think I'll be home tonight. I came out here to let you know. You'll have to pick up the medicine yourself.
Right.
One more thing. I saw a group of demons near the village. If you're attacked, run away. Am I clear?
No way! I can handle a bunch of-
Demons can only be challenged by those with the talent for exorcism. That's the cold logic of the world, and no emotions can change it.
Do you think I could become an exorcist?
Why is it you think that birds fly?
Why? Well, without flying, they couldn't find food.
It takes a particular innate talent to be an exorcist. Unfortunately, very few humans have it within themselves.
All right.
Tomorrow is Celica's Memorial Day. I'll be back as soon as I can.
Hurry back! I'll make you a quiche, just the way she taught me. I wonder if those prickle boars were brothers. Maybe I should have let them go. But then how would I pay for Laffy's medicine? Hunting took care of that. And it means food for us as well. I had no other choice. It was a rational decision. But the fact that I'm still worrying about it shows that my feelings are getting the better of me.
Groceries?
Yep. And you must have been out hunting.
Yeah, it was a good haul.
Look at you, Lady Breadwinner.
If you were a boy,
I think I'd be in love.
Good thing I'm a girl.
Oh, yeah?
You ought to do something about your style, then.
Yeah. I kind of broke my comb.
So get a new one.
Sure, I'd like to, but...
Hey, mister! How about a sale on combs for the pretty girl?
Huh? Oh, you two need something?
I'm fine, Nico. I'm just here to pick up medicine for Lafayette.
Oh, Velvet. I already told Arthur, but I'm afraid the medicine hasn't come in yet.
What? Why not? Is it because of the demons?
Seems like the demon blight's really taking a toll on the city. There's even a group of them lurking around here now.
When's it coming, then?
I can't say. And I don't know how much it will cost.
Oh, no.
Ugh, what is wrong with Midgand?
I mean, don't they have an army or something?
Those guys? The demons already routed them a while back.
But... we're safe here, right? After all, your brother-in-law's an exorcist.
You so sure about that? Arthur can't even use his right hand anymore. Poor fellow couldn't even protect his own wife and child.
Let me know when the medicine gets in.
Of course. For now, Here, on the house.
Velvet!
You didn't forget, did you?
You promised to teach me how to make your special quiche!
You mean for that apprentice animal doctor you had your eye on? You were serious?
Beyond serious!
Please, this is life or death for me. But I thought your folks weren't keen on the two of you dating.
Who cares what people think? The important thing is my feelings.
I like the way you talk. If I were a boy, I think I'd be in love.
Darn right!
Luffy must be starving by now. I'd better hurry home.
Ever since the opening 7 years ago, this world's really gone crazy. Famine, freezing weather, and worst of all, this demon blight that's turning people into monsters.
I can't believe that people can really turn into those things. It's a nightmare.
Does no one know what causes demon blight? Or how to heal it?
No. What we do know is that when people turn into those monsters, I mean, demons, they gain incredible strength and attack humans on sight.
Whoever named it the opening named it right. It's like someone opened a portal directly to hell.
Come to think of it, Celica died during the opening, didn't she? It might be a good thing she died when she did. She didn't have to suffer through all of this.
It's good that my sister died? How can you say that?
Sorry. I didn't mean it that way.
You're a real idiot, you know that?
Sorry about him, Velvet.
Hi, Celica. I'm back. I can't believe it's been 7 years since we lost you. And the baby you carried. Oh, drat. I forgot to bring your princessias. I know how much you, Mom, and Dad all loved those flowers. And I know your child would have too. I'm sorry. I'll pick some from the cake tomorrow.
Welcome home, Velvet.
Luffy, I told you to stay in bed.
I was only up for a little.
Look, your fever hasn't gone down a bit. Go lie down and I'll cook dinner.
I'm sorry.
What's this?
A compass. It uses a magnet to tell you which way you're facing.
Woohoo! You can use the sun and stars for that.
And what'll you do if it's cloudy, huh? Thanks to this invention, we'll even be able to voyage across the ocean. See? It's designed to stay level, so your heading will be true even when the ship is rolling with the waves. Pretty neat, right?
If you say so, Luffy.
Come on, it's a must-have for any adventure. Can't you see how useful it is?
You can tell me more about it later.
Did they hurt you?
Not a scratch, and I brought back plenty. I can hear Arthur already.
Gosh, Velvet, I think it's time you learned all my secret arts.
He isn't coming home tonight, is he?
How do you know that?
Sarah stopped by and told me.
Arthur's Moloch? Huh, you really can talk to Molochim, can't you?
Yeah, Arthur says I've got exorcist potential.
No kidding. I think you'll be an exorcist to rival even him.
I can tell you've been learning all sorts of things from his book collection.
I really want to become an exorcist. I want to go traveling with you and see all the wonders of the world. I'll hunt and chop firewood, and if demons come for us, I'll defend you. I wish I could do that.
You'll get there, Lafayette. It should only take... 20 years tops.
It won't take me that long.
Oh yeah? You better prove it to me then.
Start with this lovely meatball stew I cooked. Eat every last mouthful, even if you don't feel hungry. And take your medicine, no matter how nasty it tastes. No tricks. Am I clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Right, cooking time. First, I need to light the stove.
So easy to light Arthur's firewood. I wonder what his trick is.
Velvet? Could you not put any spinach in the stew?
Huh. You'll never grow up if you're picky with your food, you know.
I know. But just for today?
Fine. I'll leave out the spinach just this once. And I'll make it that curry flavor you like.
Really? Thanks, Velvet!
There's some of Arthur's special curry spice upstairs, isn't there? Isn't this Arthur's book? Is Luffy really reading stuff this dense? Poor kid's gonna squint his eyes right out.
The day before Scarlet Night, Sis went prickle boar hunting on her own. She's almost as good a fighter as Arthur. So I know those prickle boars don't stand a chance. But I worry that she's too athletic to land a husband. Maybe she should try to be more ladylike.
Little scamp. He just knew I'd be reading this, didn't he? There you go. Not spicy hot, but oh so delicious. Oh yeah. I saw Nico today, and she had very important things to talk about. She's coming over in the next couple days, so be on your best behavior.
I will. I'm glad you've got a good friend.
Yeah, we've known each other since forever. Still, Nico falling in love? I can barely wrap my head around it. Luffy, you know, if there's a girl you like, you'll tell Big Sister all about it, right?
A girl?
You're a stubborn little brat, so you might need an older girl to keep you under control. Oh, and she's gotta be a good cook. A pro in the kitchen is a success at life.
Knock it off, Velvet! You should be more worried about your own love life.
Me? I've got enough on my mind. For one thing, I've got to cook for you and Arthur since Celica is gone. Besides, getting crushes on strange men? I just don't see what's so... Luffy, what's wrong? Are you all right? I'll bring you some water.
I'm fine. You just said something funny is all, and it made me choke a bit.
As long as you're okay. Sorry, I went off on a tangent there.
Who knows what the future holds?
Yeah, but what more can I do? I've got a duty to look after my little brother, and I'm serious about it.
I know, but I'm trying to look after you too. I want you to be happy. That's all. And it's not just me. Arthur worries about you too.
Well, we're family, right?
Yeah, that's what families do.
Thanks, Luffy. For you, I'd kill every last prickle boar in the forest if it came down to it. What am I doing? I need to hurry and get dinner ready. Good boy, you didn't forget your medicine.
Well, I did promise. Tomorrow's a scarlet night.
Yeah, just like that night that changed our lives.
Velvet, may I sleep next to you tonight?
Of course. Today, I've got to dry some meat and use that cheese I've been saving to make a quiche for... Luffy? You little... Where have you gone? You better not have gone to the village alone! I bet your fever hasn't even gone down! Been here?
No. I haven't seen him.
Wait! That's one of Arthur's!
Actually, it's a copy that Lafayette made. A smart merchant would pay a pretty penny for this book. I gave him a fair trade.
Luffy, did he really copy all that by hand? Oh, he must have done it to buy that compass.
No, though he gave it some puppy eyes. Told him I'd throw it in for free, but he said that it would be a bad deal for me. He's a good lad, but not the merchant type.
So, what did he use the money for?
I'm afraid my lips are sealed. You'll have to ask him.
Velvet! I saw Luffy set walking around. Is he okay?
He's not okay. Where'd you see him?
He was headed for the forest. I'll help you look for him.
Thanks. Do a sweep of the village, just in case. I'll check the forest.
Hey, Velvet, did you hear the news? Tonight is going to be another Scarlet Night!
I remember the moon turned red 7 years ago. But what is it anyway?
It's a red lunar eclipse. It happens every several years or so. Apparently, you can predict the next one by watching the movements of the stars. According to legend, a crimson moon is a gate that connects our world to the next. It's also said to be proof of humanity's sins.
You sure know a lot about it.
Luffy said taught me, just a few minutes ago.
You saw Luffy? Where'd he go?
Actually, I don't know. Sorry.
Aww.
Taking a break.
Oh, you little... You know better than this, Luffy said. Running off without telling me. What if something happened to you? You wouldn't be the only one hurt. Do you understand that?
I'm sorry.
If you want to do something, just ask. I know I'm a crummy big sister, and I can't afford to buy you all the things you want.
No, that's not why I went out. You see, it was just...
I get it. You're right. I forgot the flowers for the graves.
Yeah, so I was going out to the Cape, and I thought...
You want to see the ocean too, don't you?
Well, yeah, that too.
Fine. Just for today, though.
Are you sure?
I am. But next time you run off like that, I'm strapping you to your bed.
Yes, ma'am.
Good. It's off to the Cape, then.
Hooray!
Remember how we went out together to pick Princessias on the morning of Celica's funeral?
Yeah. I was only 4, but I remember. We couldn't find any in the village or at the Cape.
Right. Because the demons had made a mess of them. And then you suddenly started climbing down the edge of the cliff.
You ran over and grabbed me. You had the scariest look on your face.
Of course I did. Do you have any idea what I'd do if I lost you too?
You'd still have Arthur. He'd help you. He'll help the world. He's quite the guy.
That's probably true. But I'd still miss you like you wouldn't believe.
I know. I'm sorry, sis.
But down the cliff from where you were, a lone pair of Princessia were blooming.
I remember. A gentle breeze came in, and it smelled like Celica.
That's right. That's why I believe those flowers were a message from her. Do you know what Princessia flowers signify?
An irreplaceable treasure, and wishes for good health for many years to come.
Right. And that sums up my feelings nicely, Luffy.
Yeah. Me too, sis.
How about I make you some apple boo when we get home, Luffy?
Apple boo? What's that?
Grated apples. Whenever I caught a cold when I was little, Celica would make it for me. It's sweet and tart and juicy and crisp. Eating it always made me feel better.
Well, apples are good for you. But what does the boo mean?
When I was a baby, I would always say boo-boo when I wanted to eat an apple.
So that's where the name comes from. Wait, you called apples boo-boo? You must have been a strange baby.
You used to do the same thing. When Celica and I heard you, we laughed so hard.
Boo!
Right, here goes!
Is that all? This place never changes, does it?
It does too change. The seasons, the wind, the weather. Change one and the sea's totally different. And the same goes for what lies across the sea.
Across the sea? Sometimes I just don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, Velvet. Thank you for taking me out here today.
You don't need to thank me. Hey, Luffy. Do you know why it is that birds fly?
Well, if they didn't, they couldn't catch food or escape from predators.
Thought so.
But you know, I think there's more to it than that. A bird that's born with wings has to...
A demon! Luffy said, run! No matter how much it hurts, run! Velvet!
Don't be scared. You can do it. You're going to be strong, like Arthur.
No, you can't! Arthur said. I have to do this! Stop! Face me, demon! Velvet. Is this why? Get home.
Velvet!
Luffy, you're all right.
Sorry, it's all my fault.
No, if you weren't there, there's no telling what might have happened to me.
Your old one broke, right? You've got beautiful hair. It would be a waste if you didn't take care of it. I'll make a new world. A world where my sister can be happy.
Was it all a dream? No, it wasn't!
Thank you.
Lavi's safe, didn't you, Arthur?
One more sentiment to cast off.
Velvet, run! Arthur!
Here, once, was the seal to the underworld broken. And tonight, here shall be born the power to save the world. With Lucky's life as a sacrifice.
What? What are you saying?
Go. This is an offering to the world.
Why would you?
Nothing can save him now.
No, no, no!
I see you will not change. Ever a slave to emotion.
On your hands! Back to me! Back to me! Why?
take a look around. Demon light has spread through the village. But do not fear. With my power as an exorcist, I, Artorius Colbrand, will end your pain. Why is it that birds fly? Behold my answer. Velvet.
Arthur.
I ask no forgiveness. The sin is mine to bear.
I will make you pay.
So did my world come to an end. And for 3 long years, I sat in that pit of darkness and fed. Devouring demons. So I could live. So I could live long enough to kill him and be my brother's vengeance.
Is he? First, there will be a test. It will decide if you are worth teaching. If you are not, I will kill you. Ready yourself. Turn like a sun!
Yeah.
Why are you holding back?
You noticed. Well done. You pass.
Of course. His Moloch would never be so weak as that.
I am his Moloch no longer. First, let me tell you what has transpired these past 3 years. There are exorcists now throughout the land, challenging the reign of demons with the help of...
Tell me. Tell me where Artorias is.
You may find him in the capital city of Logris, in Midgand. You won't stop to listen. I can tell you what it was you saw that night. That night, the ritual he performed shifted the very course of the world. A host of Malachim descended, and with their strength, the emergent exorcist quelled the demon tide. Now, he serves as leader of the Exorcist's Abbey, an institution that enjoys the unconditional faith of the kingdom and public. A shield to guard the people and a sword against demons, Artorias Colbrand, the world's savior.
With power stolen by sacrificing Lafayette.
Indeed. But his power is not yet absolute. The man can still be killed.
Why are you doing this?
Make a successful escape from this place, and I'll explain.
Escape? So that's your game. Fine. I don't care what the world thinks of me. What matters is my vengeance against Artorias. That's all.
I have shattered your yoke. We must hurry. Equipment. There are weapons in the room ahead. No one raised the alarm.
I can see that.
Take what you need from here. It looks like they kept prisoners' effects in here.
Rope. This will be useful. Quite a blade.
I know that sword. Stormhowl! What is it doing here?
Well... It's too big for me.
You're not taking it? It's a celebrated masterpiece.
And if I can't use it, it's worthless. All right.
Are you ready then?
What's going on here?
Be careful. He's no ordinary soldier. He's an exorcist orderly.
Burning me!
You didn't even flinch.
I already told you. I am his Moloch no longer.
Is there a ship waiting?
So you already know we're on an island?
Yes. I've learned that this is a prison island for violent criminals, and that there are scores of demons locked away here. Demons say lots of things when they don't want you to eat them.
The prison has docks at both the front and rear entrances. Our ship is on the back side.
Got it. The back docks. What is this thing?
That's a special mass of mana. Think of them as the souls belonging to a family of Molochim. They appeared all over after the Advent 3 years ago.
Another after effect of the Advent.
If you collect enough of them, you might be able to solicit the cooperation of a Moloch family.
And I'm supposed to take your word for it?
I'm not forcing you to do anything. Whether you collect them or not is up to you.
I might as well pick them up. I'll use every tool at my disposal.
Indeed. You'll have to if you want your revenge. Guards coming. Two of them.
This way.
Did you hear? The path around the island is off limits now. They say the ground's weak and could collapse.
The path that goes under the watchtower? That's alright. Nobody uses it anyway.
True, but it was a nice shortcut to the docks.
A shortcut to the docks. Under the watchtower.
A number of guards have gone missing. It would seem we have intruders on the island.
All exorcists, break into two groups and converge at the front and rear gates.
Understood. No one will get past us.
Stay sharp. The threat could be serious.
Yes, sir.
This isn't going to be easy.
Then we'll need reinforcements of our own. Where are the cells?
They should be on this floor. You plan on involving the other prisoners?
I'll use any tool I have at my disposal.
Here I come!
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
door to every cell! We're getting off this island!
What the hell? You serious?
Split into two groups and rush the front and rear gates! Break through the gates and you'll have a ship!
But aren't they guarded by exorcists? I mean, that pirate Von Eifring's the only one who's ever broken out of here!
And he didn't pull it off just by himself. He was hauled out by some old exorcist named Melchior or something.
Von Eifring? Melchior?
I won't force you! You wanna rot in here, then rot!
I'm with you! Anything's better than another day in this wreck.
I'm going home to my family!
Me too!
Yeah.
Let me out,
yeah,
girl!
Like us are always
I'm
up for
sick
you.
Of the slop they feed us!
Ceres.
Let's go! We'll murder those exorcists!
Open all the doors!
That ought to draw the attention of the guards. In the meantime, we'll search for that watchtower. From there, we can follow the outer path down to the docks.
So you're leaving them all to their fates?
I told you. We'll use any tool I need. You're not going to escape.
Don't underestimate the exorcists. They're all gonna die like dogs. Or goblins.
This abbey that's in charge of this place. They're that amazing.
Amazing doesn't even begin to cover it. The exorcists of the abbey joined forces with the kingdom of Midgan. And they've got the whole world in their pocket. They're merciless. They hunt down any human who becomes a demon. Going against them means taking on the whole world.
And I bet I know who's at the top.
Those who get captured and sent here are the lucky ones. We may be monsters, but at least we have our lives.
Sure, until they get fed to me. Thanks for the info.
Even if you manage to escape this place, thousands of exorcists controlling powerful Molochine will be out there waiting for you. There's nowhere for you to run. Nowhere.
I'm not going to run. I'll gladly die, as long as I take Artorias with me.
Short.
Magilu?
No, Ma! Like Saki
shoo, or doggy doo, or call me any of those things and I'll turn you into a froggy stew!
I suppose you'll never understand. People can be so tragically unlearned. But hey, like I care!
I can't believe she snuck up on me. Who is she?
This is no ordinary prison. We must be cautious. Trust no one. She said she's a powerful witch.
Did she have a Moloch tethered?
No, I didn't sense Molochim around her. She's an ordinary human, I think.
Then she's an ordinary magician, not a witch. If she tries to trick me again, I'll crush her and be done with it.
More?
This one. He's a demon! Get ready!
I'll stop you!
You're not human.
Neither are you.
True enough.
I'll stop you!
Burning Wing!
I'll stop you! Deception!
Burning Wing!
He's strong.
Chips in the blades already. Brittle these exorcist knives. Gotta reclaim Storm Howl.
Storm Howl? That sword we found?
Found it? Where? Do you have it? Please tell me.
It's in a storage room. Down below.
Down below? You have my thanks.
He's an odd demon. If things settle down, we'll miss our window. Hurry!
Demon be?
What is it?
Nothing. The demon swordsman was just strange. He was so full of fury, but when you started talking about that sword, his manner changed completely.
Don't think too much about it. He's a demon after all.
The prisoners here are all so unusual. Except for you.
Forget it. Like I care what a Moloch thinks of me.
Thank you. We're finished here. Let's hurry on.
Getting out of here comes first. They've got the gate to the docks locked down. We can't break through.
The tower should be just ahead.
We've just about quelled this riot. You won't be getting away.
The prisoners are doomed.
Time is short. We need to get down to the path. The path has collapsed. That rope won't do any good here. Wait, you're not seriously going to try it, are you? He fell further than this back at the shrine.
I see you are truly committed to this. You're strong. I would almost think you made an oath. It's a ritual that grants special power, but the oath taker abides by certain restrictions. The harsher the restrictions, the greater the power one may command. In a very real sense, an oath is a sort of curse, right?
Well, guess what? You're the ones who did this to me.
I am aware. That is why I chose you.
We're finished here. Let's go.
you sure? This way leads to the main entrance.
If they know you're here, they'll have found your ship by now. The guards expect us at the rear, not the front. We're almost there.
That's enough.
Oscar, I had no idea an Exorcist Praetor had been assigned to this island.
You surprise me, Ceres. Aiding criminals now, are you? Did Lord Artorias request this?
No, I'm acting on my own.
A mullet with free will? And yet, I sense someone's strings guiding you.
Hold on. Praetor is far more dangerous than an orderly.
I'm all out of subterfuge. And besides, if we can't overpower this one, our end goal was hopeless to begin with.
You're a demon, but still a lady, so I'll show you due respect. I am Oscar Dragonia, Praetor of the Abbey of the Holy Midgand Empire. Who might you be?
Huh.
All right. Graceless demon it is, then. Lord Artorias himself taught me the ways of purification. How will you fare against them? Skilled. I will have to expend a mollock or two for this.
What are you doing?
The feelings to control the
end
of battle!
More of your vaunted reason!
Please, consume me.
I'm not about to.
My form is bound by an oath whose price is my life. The time has come to pay. Feeding on my form will grant you strength, the strength to press forward. I ask only that you devour me.
Why?
A flame burns in my heart, too. A flame I cannot quench, no matter how hard I try. Just like you, Velvet.
This was Lavi's.
That is why I cannot abide it. This frozen world. This frozen people. I'm just that stubborn of a woman. Hurry. Before my life fades, do it now.
Ah.
I offer no apology or thanks.
I need neither. Our wishes... are one and the same. I treasured those days. When you and I... and Arthur were... together.
Absorb that Moloch's power to wield as her own? I've never seen such a demon! But I can't let a nasty demon like you roam freely now, can I?
Velvet! That's my name. You can give Artorias my regards. My name is Velvet Crow, and I will devour demon, Moloch, and exorcists alike! I am a monster! I am a Therian!
Aha!
place that might not be a death trap. When we tumbled from the tower, I thought, this is it, Moggy Lou. This is the end!
It would have been less risky if you hadn't suddenly appeared and jumped on my back. Oh, hey, it's you. It's thanks to you that Storm Howl is back in my care. Rokuro Rangetsu, at your service. This blade is my life. I owe you a great debt, one I vow to repay.
Yes, yes, she's a peach and a model citizen. Can we get our move on? I think they're just about done massacring the rioters.
The docks are just ahead. Give me a hand.
Guess the weather's feeling as crummy as I am.
Careful. Sea's looking mighty choppy.
Are you a sailor?
No, but I do know the difference between a sail and a rudder.
I'll take what I can get. Do what you can.
You're leaving without a proper crew?
Very well, then. I certainly owe you this much, at least.
Brave words! But 10 minutes in this storm, and you'll lose all sense of direction.
No, we won't. Ships have compasses for a reason.
So it's rot in a jail cell, or rot in a fish tummy? Well, guess it's your lucky day, fishies!
I'm coming for you, Artorias.
Sorry. If I had a weapon, I would have helped. I promise.
You're wearing one.
Oh, nah, I can't use this. Sorry, long story.
And the child?
The little brat? Scampered off somewhere.
You ought to be scampering off yourselves.
My debt is not yet repaid. Until it is, I will not leave your side.
I can hardly scamper off without knowing from whence I'm scampering! We're lost, stranded shipwreck survivors, no?
Well, then I expect this might come in handy.
A map? Was that left by the child?
Looks to me like we're in Northgand.
Northgand? Then if we're to reach the capital in Midgand, we've no choice but to patch up our ship.
What are your plans once you reach Logris? Something worth breaking out of prison for.
Can't we stand around and chat somewhere nicer? Somewhere with soup to warm the body, tails to warm the heart?
There's a city called Helleby's nearby. I can't promise there much for conversation, but we'll find food and a ship right there.
Velvet, you know that kid? I thought I heard you call him by name.
No, I don't know any Malakim. Not anymore.
Anymore?
What?
Well, whoever he was, there was something different about him, that's for sure.
You can say that again. Using healing arts on a demon without being ordered to?
And he stole that compass, too. For being an exorcist Moloch, he's a greedy little imp.
Well, we did help ourselves to a certain map of his, so...
I consider myself an island of virtue in this sea of wickedness.
I suppose.
Come on, it's not funny if you agree with me.
You think?
So this is how escaped prisoners behave.
Mogilu, your way of speaking is as strange as your appearance.
Hey, I'm a witch. I must project a proper age and dignity. I have an image to maintain.
Self-improvement in all things, I suppose. So what's the difference between a spellcaster and a witch?
There are many, but mainly it's a matter of nuance. It's like the difference between being frugal and being miserly.
Ah, so a spellcaster is useful and a witch isn't, is that it? So I guess that makes you a witch right now.
You wound me! You're one to talk, Mr. Self-Improvement! Your words cut deeper than these northern winds! It bites! How can you stand wearing that garb? It doesn't seem humanly possible!
I never said I was human.
Yeah.
really?
So nice to be free again, able to move these bones around like I want.
So, Rokuro, what got you all chained up in that mold hole?
Ties to home. It's complicated.
Oh! Then are you really sure you ought to be taking on further debts?
It's a teaching of House Ron gets. Pay what you owe.
Well, what a civilized family you've got.
Were you in for long?
3 years, maybe. That's why I know so little about the state of the world.
Gosh, me too! Art-wielding Malakim! I've never seen such a thing! How much else have I missed? Used to be witches who had a monopoly on charms and hexes. Can you even comprehend what this'll do to business?
Should I even ask why you were imprisoned?
Ha! Bagged for unlicensed witchcraft. It was a tale of betrayal most wicked and foul! Care to hear more? You'll cry. I'll laugh! Emotions will touch the rafters!
No, thank you.
Help a kitty out, meow.
Oh, look, another weirdo.
That thing talks? What if it's a cat demon?
Simmer down, big man. She's just a cat. Haven't seen one in a good long while.
Cats? Is that different from a regular cat somehow?
It's complicated. Cats are a mysterious bunch. Just think of them as a special kind of Moloch. Sort of.
That works for me. I understand that they're hard to understand, at least.
Hey, I don't suppose you happen to be carrying any cat spirits on you? They look like this!
That's just like what I found at Titania.
Perfect! You could say they're kinda like our souls to us.
Cat spirits, huh?
Sometimes we call them kitten caboodles, too!
That's just foolish.
Really? Then how about kitty clumps? Anyway, one night we were having a feast so meowvelous, our souls flew right out of our bodies! That's why I need your help to find the cat spirits and use them to emeowsipate my friends!
Emeowsipate? Really?
It means to use cat spirits to free cats who are locked away in cat's boxes like these here, meow. Here you'd say apesipate. This one would be edoxipate. And finally...
I'm free, meow.
See? Emeowsipate.
By that logic, shouldn't it be ecatsipate?
Wow, you're way more clever than you look! For real! I guess I totally underestimated you. Please, our cat spirits got scattered far and wide, and so many sad cats are trapped without them!
Seek out the cat spirits and rescue our poor lost brothers and sisters, meow!
And why should I?
Please, think of the cats!
You know, cats have weird and mysterious powers. There's a good chance we might benefit by having them in our debt. We'll make it worth your while, I promise! And if we snub them, they might put a curse on us.
That has been known to happen.
You.
Ever doing all this traveling anyway? Why not help them on the side?
Just remember that it's on the side. Exorcists.
Well, that's just inconsiderate. Word of the prison break couldn't have traveled so quickly.
I somehow doubt they'll just let us in looking the way we do.
I apologize about earlier. I didn't mean to steal this.
The compass.
You okay with this? He could be working for the exorcists.
I'm following him.
Is he your dessert?
If necessary.
He must have gone this way.
There's a ladder. Storehouse?
That smell. Flamestone.
Flamestone?
Also known as Malkianite, a rare mineral only found in Northgand. Mix it with sulfur and you get explosives! Mix it with oil and you get fuel!
Sounds dangerous, if it's true.
Believe me or not, it's your call.
Looks like the boy got away.
Well, we're in the city now.
Well, then let's scout for the Maritime Guild. Whoever's in charge of all these storehouses must have their hands in the shipping trade and shipbuilding.
And we could use a true sailor, if we can find one.
Now that's a plan I endorse! We dodged the sea's murderous grasp this time, but who's to say our luck will hold?
We should look for some weapons, too, if I'm to be any use in a fight.
You're still wearing one.
Nope, not an option.
Me too! I want to protect my mommy and daddy!
Hold up! Exorcists are warriors who protect the whole world from demons! You can't just protect your parents, you've got to protect everyone!
Oh, that sounds really hard.
It is! And it's precisely because the exorcists are working so hard that we look up to them!
Yeah! Exorcists are the best!
They're treated like heroes. I suppose to normal people, they are.
Thank you.
There's a group of sailors. Is that the guild?
Oh, hey, that weapon shop looks promising. Good luck with the shipwright search.
Boys, poor creatures just can't be separated from their favorite toys, can they?
It's true. Is this a shipping guild?
Damn that dial! What does he think he's doing by trying to resist? We wouldn't be in this mess if he were dead.
Excuse me. We need a ship repaired.
Sorry, but we can't help.
What makes you say that?
Guild business is currently suspended. By the order of Exorcist Teresa of the Abbey.
Lady Teresa.
Number two, did I give you permission to speak?
Lady Teresa, how long must this punishment of ours last? You know it was all Dial's fault, don't you, my lady?
I know Dial was the one smuggling Flamestone, but your guild, through its negligence, shares responsibility. This rule was set down by the Abbey to maintain order. Do you disagree with it?
No, my lady.
We will capture, interrogate, and sentence Dial. When this has been accomplished, you will be free to continue business. And you, girl. Aren't you cold dressed like that?
I just arrived from the south. I wasn't aware Northgown was so cold.
A young woman ought to keep herself warm.
Thank you for your concern.
My, my! So this is how the Abbey flexes its muscle, hmm? Cruel, cruel world these days.
I see how things stand. If I catch this Dial person, you can repair my ship, right?
Sure, but I warn you. He's a demon. He escaped after killing a bunch of soldiers who tried to capture him. Can't be done without an exorcist.
He's from a small village outside the city. If you're doing this, I'd imagine that's a good place to start searching. He's a brute with the head of a lizard. I'd prepare for bloodshed.
Hey!
Anything could happen. It's best to keep our options open.
While you wait, find us a good navigator.
I wonder what darling Rokuro's got up to in the meantime.
Let's check in on him at the weapon shop.
Found a real good one. The blade was badly rusted, but once I polished it up, it turned out to have a fine edge.
I can scarcely believe something of that quality was languishing in my bargain bin. You've taught me quite a lesson. The weapon is yours as payment.
My thanks.
So you'll help us out?
Of course. How did your errand fare? I see. So we're hunting a reptilian demon called Dial, are we?
We'll check out his hometown first.
Have fun, you kids!
You aren't coming along?
I'm afraid I've got bigger fish.
My palate has standards. High standards.
All the more reason to skedaddle!
Look, a yak. Hey, Velvet, here's a fun fact. Yak tail hair is considered to be among the highest quality materials for a helmet's plume.
Wow, really? Also, I don't care.
At my house, we had this helmet. It was an incredible piece, covered with yak tail hair. The talk of the town. House Rangetsu has two treasures going for it, people would say. The Helm of Yak and Storm Howl.
They must not have thought very highly of the rest of you.
Hmm? Why do you say that? Although, I guess I can think of a reason or two. Oh well, it's nothing a demon like me has to worry about.
Did you hear? That navigator for the shipping guild, Dial, he turned into a demon. He supposedly killed and ate his crewmates, then ran off.
Demon Blight? In Helavise? What do we do?
No need to worry. Lady Teresa is already dealing with it. She'll hunt down that Dial character in no time.
They say that once you change, you can never turn back into a human. Is killing him our only option?
Killing him would be a mercy. Demons are just monsters who've lost their humanity.
Yeah, you're right. Things like that aren't human anymore.
Not human, huh?
This straight, Alpha Area. You want to form an alliance with my Gamma Area to bring down the Betas?
Correct. It's the classic strategy. Ally with a distant state and strike a neighboring one.
What is this? A council of war?
The enemy of my enemy is my friend. Is that it? Indeed. If your Alpha forces and my Gamma forces work together, Beta Area is done for.
I like it.
You've got yourself an alliance, Alpha Area.
Excellent! We shall be victorious in this year's Helavise Grand Snowball Fight! Let us toast to our victory!
This isn't a snowball fight, it's a snowball war!
Fools! I was the one who engineered their alliance! Once they eliminate Beta Area, the Alpha and Gamma forces will launch a full-scale assault to destroy the other. Exhausted, the victor won't be prepared when my Delta Army sweeps down upon them! They have sealed their own doom.
These kids really fight dirty.
All's fair in snow and war.
This cold is beyond ordinary. Well, Helavise is a northern country, but still, it wasn't this cold when I was a kid. The cold, snow, and ice were never this bad. I know it for a fact.
It's that... what do they call it again?
Global cooling?
Yeah, that's the one. The Abbey says the world's getting colder.
Thanks to all this cold, I need more warm clothing. Worse, I have to shovel snow and chop firewood all day! Ugh. Who's responsible for this global cooling? Let me at him!
Well, don't look at me. It's not my fault.
Thank you.
What a beautiful ship.
Isn't she? She transports Flamestone and Sulfur to the capital in Midgand. Have you heard of Flamestone? It's this new explosive material the Abbey developed. Thanks to their discovery, we can make some really powerful new cannons and explosives.
Explosives? Sounds dangerous.
It is dangerous, but it's also necessary. Not only are there demons about, but we've humans to contend with too. With pirates and bandits in ever-increasing numbers. On the bright side, with a higher demand for Flamestone, Helavise is prospering like never before. Flamestone is the only reason our little snowbound city is thriving. A keel haul to anyone who says otherwise.
So this ship goes to the capital. If I asked, could you take us with you?
Nope, not happening. The Guild ordered a total suspension of activity. We can't lift anchor. Besides, any ship carrying precious ores has an exorcist on board for security. You need the Abbey's permission.
Sounds like they keep a tight lid on things.
Yeah, I guess. But the Abbey makes the rules, so what are you gonna do? Without the Abbey, humanity would be dead in the water. A keel haul to anyone that says otherwise.
But ice and snow as far as the eye can see.
Are you cold?
I'm fine, but I'm not the one with the exposed midriff.
Doesn't bother me either. And watch where you let your eyes wander.
Hey there, sorry. I meant no offense. So you still retain feelings like shame then?
Wait, you don't?
Me? I've lost a lot of my human feelings. I figured that was just part of turning into a demon.
I didn't know that.
But deep down, I'm still the same person I always was. And I can still enjoy a good drink. I'm glad I haven't lost that, at least.
If you say so.
Don't waste my time!
Your style is really unique.
Just wait until I pull out the good stuff.
Don't waste my time.
See this? Oh, stop!
I unleashed all my power. Maybe I overdid it.
I'll end this quickly.
One more! One more!
Come on, really?
Don't waste my time.
Well then, let's move on. Look, there's something growing all the way out here. That is one gutsy flower.
It's a princessia.
That's quite an elegant name.
My sister loved them.
I see. Thank you. And everybody's in position, I take it?
Yes. Preparations are underway now. We're all looking forward to it.
Not much longer. Keep up the good work.
Of course.
If anyone can succeed, it's you, sir.
Time is nigh, Sevica. Time to do what needs to be done. For you, for him, for everyone. Is something the matter, Velvet?
Oh, no, I just didn't want to disturb you.
Perish the thought. You're not disturbing anyone. She's your sister, too.
I know, I just figured that, well, she loved you the most out of all of us. And that, you also loved her more than anyone else, so...
Velvet, there's no ranking among family. Selica, Lafayette, you. You're all very important to me.
Yeah, you're right.
It's almost the anniversary of her death. I better go to the Cape and pick her up, Princessia.
That's a good idea. I'm sure that would make her happy.
Yes. I really hope it does.
That snake Artorias.
They say flowers have different meanings and stuff, right? Any idea what princessias signify?
Betrayal.
Oh?
We're finished here. Let's go.
Oh.
You better be ready.
Deception!
Is that all you got?
They were nothing.
I see a village.
Let's go ask around.
Exorcist. Was that Dial she slew?
No. It wasn't a lizard demon. Are you crying?
It's just... everything that's going on. Demons run rampant in the Outlands, and yet the Abbey has explicitly chosen not to come to their aid. It's true we haven't the forces to be everywhere at once, and the people of the Outlands refuse to obey the Abbey's rules. It's a heartless decision, I know, but it follows from the Abbey's perfect logic and principle.
Why make excuses to me?
I'm not making... My name is Eleanor Hume. I am a praetor patrolling for the Abbey. What is your business here?
We heard there was a murderous demon in this town who fled from Hellevise.
The Shipping Guild incident, yes. I've been looking into it, but I haven't found any clues yet. Worry not. We will track down that foul demon and put it to the sword.
Did the exorcist lady go away?
Yeah, she's gone.
Oh, good. I didn't want us to get eaten.
Eaten?
I don't know anything about a demon.
It's fine. You can tell me. I'll keep it a secret, I promise.
There's a lizard demon in a cave to the north. He said he'd eat the whole village up if I told anyone. I'll give you these. Don't tell anybody, all right?
Got it. That's a promise.
A cave to the north.
Gotta say, the folks here really don't trust the exorcists, do they? This is actually rather good. What's wrong? A worm?
Nothing. Can't taste a thing. We learned what we need to. Let's look for that cave. That woman said she was patrolling for the Abbey. What's that mean exactly?
They're handpicked agents who travel the kingdom gauging the Abbey's success in the demon fight. They also make sure the other exorcists are conducting themselves properly. I suppose you could liken them to military police. Since the Abbey imposes so many rules on the populace, they want to show they're above board.
But if they need to police themselves, isn't that as good as announcing corruption in the ranks?
Some would say it's more honest this way. Idealism alone won't change the world. Maybe that's why our determined little exorcist was crying.
I bet you're right. That does fit the picture.
Although it's best not to take a woman's tears at face value.
Huh?
Just some common wisdom. This village seems much more run down than Hellevise was.
This is where the Abbey sends its malcontents. Don't conform or accept the Abbey's rules or commit a crime, and you'll end up here with the rest of the refuse.
And I take it the Abbey doesn't care what happens to this place.
So, disrupt their precious order, and you get banished?
Exactly. I'm sure they'd say it's all part of their notion of reason.
Oh yeah, that exorcist Eleanor said something like that.
After the advent, the exorcist showed up to quell the tide of demons and to restore the human world. But demon blight keeps spreading, and the only places they can keep safe are a few of the bigger cities. There aren't enough exorcists to protect everyone.
When the going's tough, cut off any excess baggage. It's the rational thing to do.
I suppose so, but it's too heartless. And that right there, that's the Abbey for you. Humans aren't livestock, and we're not machines either. That's why some of us here, myself included, chose to live here of our own accord.
Guess there are all types of humans out there.
The important takeaway here is that exorcists are neither invincible nor infallible.
My granddaughter said she spoke with you.
Hey, hold up! It's not like we threatened her or anything.
Don't worry, I know. I gather you intend to continue your travels, yes? Then take this. It's nothing fancy, but hopefully it helps.
Nothing special.
Hit the spot. Hey, Velvet, can I ask you a question?
You can do whatever you want, but just because you ask doesn't mean you're getting an answer.
So, about that whole apple thing, you can't taste anything?
Not entirely. I can taste blood.
Nothing else?
Nothing. And I don't think I can feel full either.
You don't think? You talk like you've never had a good meal before.
I haven't. Not normal food, at least. Not since I became a demon.
So, what have you been eating?
Please. You were in that prison with me.
I'm sorry.
Forget it. This is just what I am now. As long as I have a recipe, I can still cook. And now I don't even have to worry about how it tastes.
I suppose.
Food keeps my strength up. That's all I care about.
Oh yeah, the guy at that weapon shop gave me some booze for the trip. I nearly forgot about it.
You really think it's a good idea to drink when we've got demons to fight?
A little drink'll warm me up.
I thought you couldn't feel the cold.
That's true, I suppose. Well, I'm not drinking it anyway. I'm using it for something.
Like what? Got some wounds to clean?
That's one use for it, sure. But I've got something more practical in mind. By pouring it on the pegs that hold the blade and hilt together, the wood will swell and hold everything firmly in place in battle.
You've got such a one-track mind, I swear.
That's just the kind of demon I am.
Thank you.